In this video, I will demonstrate how you can import character information from an Excel file into your database. I will import information from following file. My Excel file contains four sheets. The second sheet contains the information I will import during this import routine. The sheet contains for 12 isolates following information: a unique identifier, an MLSD sequence type, and a clonal complex number. Finally, the allele number for each of the 7 housekeeping genes is reported in the last columns. These values will be stored in a character type experiment. In Excel, it is possible to save a range of cells. This might be of interest if you only want to import part of the information that is present in a sheet. As an example, I will make a selection only containing the first 4 rows. In my database, no character type experiment has been defined yet. To create an experiment type, I press this button in the Experiments panel. I select character type from the list and press OK. In the first step, I need to specify the name. In the second step, I need to specify the type of data I will store in my experiment. I will import numerical values so I can leave the default option checked. Since all my values are integers, I do not need to alter the second setting and I can go to the last step. Since the number of characters is fixed for all samples, I have a closed data set and I can keep the selection. The layout of my card can still be changed after creation of the experiment, so I can press Finish. The character experiment is created and is added to the Experiments panel. After import, my samples will be displayed in the Database Entries panel. This panel is located on the left-hand side in the main window. The key field is a default information field. More fields can be added by right-clicking in the header of the panel or during import. When I press the import button in the main window, the second option under the topic Character Type Data allows me to import database and character information from an Excel file into my database. When I click on Import, I need to select my Excel file in the next step. All sheets are displayed in the drop-down list. If named ranges are saved with the Excel file, they are listed here as well. Since I want to import all information from the MLSD sheet, I select a sheet from the list and press Next. In this step, I need to define the import template for my data format. The column names found in the Excel file are listed under the column Source. In this grid, I can choose what information from the Excel file I would like to import into my database. The first column in my text file contains my entry IDs. To link this information to the key field, I click on the first row in the grid, press the Edit Destination button, and select the key item from the list. The grid information is automatically updated. Further, I would like to write the content of the sequence type and clonal complex columns to new information fields in my database. With the Ctrl key, I can select multiple rows in the grid. I then select Edit Destination and select Entry Info field from the list. I am prompted to give my fields a name. The column names that appear in my file are suggested but can be changed if desired. After confirmation, the grid is updated. Finally, I would like to link my other fields to the MLST character type in my database. With the Shift key, I can select the rows in the grid. I then select Edit Destination and select a character type from the list. I am prompted to give my characters a name. The column names that appear in my file are suggested but can be changed if desired. After confirmation, the grid is updated. By clicking the Preview button, I can check whether the columns of my file have been assigned correctly. If so, I can close this window and click Next. As an entry link field, I will use the key, as this is a unique identifier for my entries. A name for my template is prompt for. Pressing OK saves the template to the database. I make sure the template is selected and press Next to go to the final step. Pressing the Finish button starts the import. The imported entry information is displayed in the Database Entries panel. For each experiment defined in the database, there is a column present in the Experiment Presence panel. This panel is located in the middle panel of the main window. Since in my database only one experiment is present, only one column is present in this panel. A colored dot is displayed if character information is linked to the entry. To view the character information of a certain entry, I can click on the corresponding colored dot. Before opening the card, I will change the default card settings. Double-clicking on the experiment opens the experiment window. The characters are listed in the upper panel. I open the settings dialog and select the experiment card tab. Since I want to see the imported values in a list, I change the representation to list and close all windows. The card can be opened by clicking on the colored dot in the middle panel. All characters and values are shown. To close the experiment card, I need to click in the upper left corner of the card. This ends this video. For other import routines, I invite you to view our other movies. Thank you for watching.